Logan
in
North Carolina.
Logan?
Are you there?
Hi. Can you guys hear me all right?
You're on, yeah.
Okay, thanks. I was just wanting to ask you guys how you dealt with people presenting you with arguments of their faith from Miracle. And because, like, I just had an evangelical Christian come up to me just last night, you know, trying to convert me to Christianity and whatnot, and his exclusive argument was arguments for a miracle. And basically what I had to do was I had to, like, he would present me with one of his, you know, vastly unsupported claims. And,
well, like, give us one. What did he say? What did he say?
Yeah.
Well, like for example, he would just say, one of my friends, you know, had a leg that was shorter than the other one, and, she watched it grow, you know, like a whole foot. Uh-huh. Yeah, and, you know, just these wild sort of claims. And, you know, I basically had to go through each one of his claims one by one and give an explanation for...
Yeah, okay, wait. I'll tell you a technique that I learned from Jeff. I like it very much.
Okay.
When somebody comes at you, and they're going to want to, like, throw as much stuff at you as you can, because they know that your time is limited, and they can take 30 seconds to say something, and you have to, like, take 10 minutes to research it.
Right.
And you just don't have the time for that. When you get somebody doing that, the first thing you need to say is, okay, hit me with your single very best miracle. Mm-hmm. Okay? What is the one thing that is the most convincing? Then you deal with that one, and then they try to change the subject, and you say, hang on, if your best miracle wasn't good enough, then why are you trying to bring up a different one?
Yeah.
You got to keep it focused, is what I'm saying.
You brought your A game, it failed, your B game is not going to work, you know. But it's, you're dealing with an irrational thinker there, right? I mean, you're dealing with someone who has just convinced himself, you know, that... these unusual, miraculous events occur. He knows that, you know, he knows that he can't prove them. He must know that he can't prove these things happen to you. I mean, how does he, you know, it all comes down to, you know, just tell him, okay, you're making extraordinary claims. They require extraordinary evidence. You know, how do I know that any of these things you're telling me actually happened? You know, he may bring up prayer as a thing. It's like, oh, well, somebody prayed that their mother would be cured from cancer, and then their mother was cured from cancer. And you're like, okay, well, what about all the other people who have cancer, and they get prayed for, and then they don't get cured from their cancer? Well, so does God mean that he just decided to like this one cancer victim on this particular day and not the millions of others? You know, miracles are just very selective things that, as Russell said, they'll just hit you with so many of them that you can't possibly refute them all.
We're running out of time, so I'm going to have to let you go. But, I mean, the one thing that I want to leave this on is that you shouldn't let anybody change the subject without strongly making a note of it. Mm-hmm. I mean, even if it's just to say, I acknowledge that you're changing the subject. Can we agree that that one wasn't good enough?